Hello dear students, myself Shweta Patil, Department of Information Technology. Today we are going to discuss the topic V model. So let's discuss the topic V model. So what is mean by V model, students? V model is nothing but the VV model. You can call it as a VV model. VV stands for verification and the validation model. So when this type of the model will be used? So VV model is basically used after the waterfall model. It is an extension for the waterfall model. Why it is an extension, students? Because in the waterfall model, we are going to see all the phases one by one. So testing can be done at the end of the cycle, but in case of the VV model, testing can be done parallelly. So this is the main advantage of the VV model. Why? Because simultaneously for the every phase we are going to take the testing. So first phase can be done, we are going to happen with the testing. Second phase done, happening with the testing. So parallel testing can be done in the VV model. So this is the best model in the life cycle. Okay, so let's discuss all the phases of the VV model or the V model one by one. Okay, so what is the first phase, students? First phase is the requirement. So requirement in terms of the user requirement. Okay, what is mean by the user requirement? We are collecting the requirement from the user. So user will give you some type of the requirement, any of the program for any website, any organizational product. So for any terms of the product, you are collecting the requirement from the user. So these requirements should be considered as a final requirement. Okay, so requirement is nothing but what? This is type of the data, something like the facts, some like the figures. Okay, so we are maintaining all the data together. So that data we are collecting from the user. Okay, so user will give all type of the requirement to the producer. Okay, second phase is what? System requirement. System requirement means what? These are the detailed requirement that could be collected from the user. Okay, so whatever the system requirement is there, that is from the user requirement as well as system requirement. Okay, so in case of system requirement, what are the parameters, what are the diagrams, what are the data, what is the fact, figures, any terminology. So everything will be maintained in case of the system. So from the user we are going to the system requirement. Okay, so this is the first point. Second phase is the system requirement. So testing can be done simultaneously, as I said earlier, that is the testing will be happen parallelly. So defect can be found easily. Okay, third phase is what? Global design. So after collecting the requirement from the user and from the system, we are going to design based on those input. So whatever the input you are going to have, we are going to design the architecture diagram of those input and we are going to test it later. Okay, so that is the global design. Next phase is a detailed design. In case of detailed design, there is an architectural diagram. So having the detailed information about each and every topic. Okay, so whatever the data elements, whatever the parameters, so everything will be detailed description will be given into the detailed design. And design is nothing but what, student? Design is the architectural diagram of your particular input. Okay, so all the inputs we have collected from the user, then we are going to apply the system requirement, then we are going to discuss the architectural diagram of those type of the input. Next, there is an implementation phase. Implementation phase is also called as what? Coding phase. Okay, implementation phase is nothing but what? Coding can be done in this type of the phase. So coding can be done based on those architectural diagram, and testing can be done simultaneously. As you can see in this diagram, everyone, this is in the V shape. Okay, you can see here, this diagram shows in the V shape. So this is called as a V model. Okay, in the waterfall, there is only from the top to bottom option is available, but it is an extension. So because of this, the shape is what? V shape. And you can see parallelly testing can be done. So this is the main advantage. Okay, parallel testing can be done. So after the implementation phase, we are going to discuss the unit test cases execution. So what is mean by unit testing? Unit testing means program testing, any class, any one module you can test. So in the software development, if you're having the one module, so for this particular one module, we are going to define the unit testing. Unit means a single, okay? Unit is nothing but what? A single testing, and that testing will always matter in the type of the testing, okay? So you are individually testing the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on unit of the modules, okay? So separately module testing is called as a unit testing. After the unit testing, there is phase that is a integration testing. Integration means what? Combining all the units together, combining all the modules together is called as integration testing. In the SDLC, you have seen that is integration means what? Combining all the modules. Suppose there are the n number of modules, then that n number of modules we are going to combine together, that forms what? Integration testing. Yes, so integration testing is majorly used in type of the testing. After the integration testing, system testing is there. What is mean by the system testing? System testing is nothing but what? It is a combination of the whole system you are going to test. Means in case you have to done the unit testing, integration means all the modules together. After all the modules, you are going to test what? Whole system. So system testing is what? It is a testing whole product before launching into the market. Okay. So whatever the product you have designed, so based on those design and the definition, you are going to test whole product. Okay. And the last phase, that is a acceptance testing. Acceptance testing means what? It is a user level testing. So whenever you are launching the product into the market, at that time what will happen? Customer will check the product is working fine or not. Okay, if the product is not working fine, then that product will be given to the producer. Okay, so that is the acceptance testing. And V model is nothing but what? V model is easy to implement, student. Okay, so these are all the phases. In the next, V model is nothing but what? There are whatever the types or the advantages are there. So we are going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages are what? It is a simple and easy to use. So of course, V model is easy to implement rather than all the models. It is working well for the small project. So it is basically used for the small project and reduce the risk of the reverse. So reworks cannot be done in the V model. Why, students? Because testing can be done simultaneously. And what are the disadvantages of the V model? It is a very rigid and the least flexible, and it is not good for the complex. Means complex project cannot be done. Okay. So this is all about the V model. Thank you everyone for the listening.